Well, so what you see going on behind us here is it's Iowans helping Iowans, right? We've got a delivery of hay, and we've got some corn stalks that are coming to down the road, and this is coming out of central Iowa up in Story County. A group of cattlemen got together and put together a couple loads here, and we knew and heard that there was a need down here in Mills County and beyond for some feed, and you know, we know that that need is great, and so we're just wanted to highlight the fact that this all happens because cattlemen want to help cattlemen, and Iowans helping Iowans, and that's a great story. And we want to remind folks too that this need for feed and for assistance down here will take. This is not something that will be solved tomorrow. This is a need that will be continue on for months. And so we just ask folks to really be mindful of that and keep that in mind and look for ways to assist those who have been impacted. We've invited Undersecretary Bill Northey, who of course knows Iowa very, very well. Bill will be back in the state. We wanted to give him a firsthand look at what's happened down here. Many of the programs that'll help our farmers get back on their feet are USDA programs, and so we want to make sure that they have a chance to see firsthand and that our farmers have a chance to visit directly with Bill. Also, Senator Grassley will be with us tomorrow, and so again, as Senator Ernst and Grassley work on disaster assistance and that will come through Congress, we want to make sure that Iowans have a chance to connect with the senator and that he has a chance to see for it with his own eyes what's happened here. So just looking to over the next couple days to visit with a lot of folks, get a sense of what's happening on the ground, and make sure that assistance hits the right spot. Look, I want to give all kinds of credit to Governor Reynolds and her team. Homeland Security, Emergency Management have done a very good job working with the emergency managers here in the county level. And I know that the governor is very interested in understanding that levee situation and what it takes to try to get that right. So again, I would commend her team for the work that they're doing here with the local folks to make sure that hopefully we can do this better in the future. It's very Iowan. We know it's happening across the border in Nebraska as well. Of course, we see that too, but I'm just very, very proud of our producers. In this case, cattlemen in central Iowa, helping out friends and colleagues down here. And again, we need this to continue. Not a bit surprised that we're seeing this kind of support and effort. And just glad to highlight that today. Right. We'll be down in Fremont County a bit today, and then we'll be visiting with folks in Mills County tomorrow. Again, a combination of some touring to actually see the flooding and some of the damage, but also then a chance to have some meetings with farmers and landowners to hear their concerns and what they need. At this point, of course, we're just moving into the recovery phase. This is something we know that does not get fixed tomorrow or next week. It's something that will take time. And from my standpoint, we want to make sure that we're there to support our producers all throughout this recovery process. And I guess the other message for folks is, we're just at the end of March here. We still have some snow melt up north. Our flooding is not done entirely this year. And so whether it's here or whether it's other parts of the state, folks need to be vigilant on what's happening and take precautions if they need to. For folks in the area who are impacted by the flooding, we always would direct traffic to the county level, their county emergency managers. I know the counties down here have websites that have lots of links as well. So that's always a very logical first point of contact for people. For our producers who are looking for assistance with USDA, get into that USDA service center. And then we also have some resources, some links on our website, iowaagriculture.gov. And I would encourage folks to visit any of those places for more information.